Welcome everyone. My name is Tom. I will tell you more about the SkyDJI framework and its implementation in Jira and Big Picture tool. As a software plant, we are a plugin vendor for Big Picture and some other solutions that create a kind of a product suite. So let's jump into the presentation. We've got a 40 slides, so it's like, well, I think we have to do this quick. So basically, my first idea is to give you a quick overview of SkyDJI framework. Just let me know who is familiar with SkyDJI framework, because there are lots of talks on SkyDJI, right? So I didn't expect that. I believe you know the whole core concept of SAVE and some very basic definitions like program increment, iteration, WSJF, and agile restrain. Are you familiar, all of you? Okay, familiar with that? Okay, great. So SAVE comes with a variety of options of complexity. So basically, you may have an essential SAVE, you may have a portfolio SAVE with a portfolio level, you may have a large solution SAVE that has a program and large solution level with no portfolio. You can have a fully fledged SAVE configuration with a portfolio and solution and program and team level, of course. And it is good to know how it works with Big Picture and Jira, how it is implemented, at least how we see its SAVE implementation in Jira. And this is the picture showing how it's currently implemented in Big Picture version 6, and it's good to know that we are going to release a Big Picture version 7 in several months. So yeah, I will show the differences. Anyway, SAVE consists of these four levels, and basically we believe that the team level is perfectly implemented using Scrum boards and all the functionalities provided by the native Jira. But there's a kind of a missing stuff here, like, you know, for managing the whole program when you have multiple teams working on the same concept, when you have streams of functionalities rather than a single Jira project or just a flat set of tasks or some very shallow hierarchy of tasks. And currently, a portfolio level is implemented as a kind of a mix of Big Picture and Kanban board combined. So you utilize Kanban board for managing your portfolio epics and Big Picture for programs that may be configured to fulfill portfolio fulfill needs on portfolio level. Currently, we are working really hard on SAVE on a Big Picture version 7 that will provide most of these functionalities. So basically, yeah, it's like a quite simplified model. Still, the Kanban board will be used on that level, on that part only, but it will, you know, much more will be covered with Big Picture. And yeah, so before I go into Big Picture, it's good to know what's the kind of a principles in project management, and because these creates also a foundation for Big Picture. So every project contains of these three concepts, so time, scope, or resources, or money, or yeah, but still it's a project. Triangle is a concept that you can only take two of these, and just take care at most of two of these, and leaving the third option as a kind of a trade-off. So basically, you may take care of time and scope, but it will cost a lot. You may think about, I've got limited resources, but I have to deliver the whole scope. So eventually, you have to be more flexible with when the feature will be, or when the product will be implemented. So big picture is built on top of these concepts. And even more, but these core concepts are represented here. So schedule is a kind of way to organize the timeline of your project with iteration, phases, program, or even portfolios. This is a kind of new concept in Big Picture 7. It is a hidden feature, not a hidden feature, but a kind of an architecture decision in Big Picture 6. And it will be fully visible and functional in Big Picture 7. And scope is realized as a work breakdown structure with a hierarchy of tasks, with lots of synchronization, etc., with an infinite hierarchy structure, with milestone dependencies, and so on. Resources is about the capacity, individual resources, or the team resources, and its capacity and its availability, planning, and then execution. And there are some other concepts that are somehow glued to these core concepts, like objectives that are very well known in SkyDJI framework, and also some kind of a risk management. So if you have already seen Big Picture, you may know that it consists of several modules, including Gantt module. And the Gantt is seen as something completely not non-agile approach for project management, which is basically it's not true, because we believe that the higher you are in a project management hierarchy, the less agile you are. It's by definition it works that way. Even on a Scrum level within a team, you may quickly decide on what will be done in that sprint, or you may quickly change the goals of the sprint. But basically, if you think about two or three iterations, you still have the issue, what are consequences of changing the plan? What are consequences of being agile? And it's even more crucial if you are on a program level. And there are very rare cases when on portfolio level, on a company strategic level, you change the strategic themes or the company strategy with a blink of an eye. It's like, it's not possible, basically. So waterfall approach is not as bad as it is seen, right? So that's why we still believe that the Gantt charting Gantt charts can be used very effectively within agile and within safe projects processes. Okay, so SAFe is quite complex methodology, lots of things in it, so I'm going to focus on the PA planning only. So basically I think all of you know this, what it is. So basically, so if you do a PA planning, it's like you need to know what needs to be done, and you need to know what resources are allocated for each Agile release train. So basically, these are the screenshots taken from Big Picture. Also some minor issues in it, but anyway. So we've got in Big Picture, you've got an ability to see a work breakdown structure view with a nice aggregation capabilities. So this hierarchy can be built down automatically. I may give you a quick demo after this presentation here, because we've got only 15 minutes left. If you have all your hierarchy built, then you can automate how the information is aggregated and displayed on this picture, you can see there's some aggregated value and statuses. So you can see the a number of stories that are completed or not, etc. And it's also available in within issue detail view. So it gives you a nice context view for a single task. So you can see in which programs the issue is available. It doesn't look, I mean, very good because of the quality of this, of the screenshots or the Beamer. But anyway, this screen shows the how you defined your Agile Restrain teams. And so there are some technical stuff, like you can synchronize your teams with Tempo. And there are some functional stuff like ability to define the multiple workload or holiday plans to your team members. So basically, if you have an individual resource, it's a very rare situation where you have one workload plan defined to that person, because during the time the person may change his part-time job to full-time job or vice versa. He or she may be unavailable for, let's say, 3 months or so, and so it has to be mapped. Such situation have to be mapped in the product. So that's why we provided this mapping capabilities. And as a result, you get a resource allocation screen with the kind of a heat map. That screen shows lots of information with lots of information expanded. But if you collapse all these tabs, you will get the kind of a heat map with green, red, or yellow colors. I don't have yellow here, yeah. But anyway, it just gives you a nice one row per each resource, showing the if a resource is over-allocated, under-allocated, or is fully allocated. We've got a new version of this screen that is currently in development. So if you see that ribbon, it means that, you know, it's either in development or it's not somehow fully available yet. And so, yeah, basically it shows almost the same information, but there are some other stuff implemented on this screen, like hourly granulation. So you may allocate a resource not for a just for a single task as a whole, but you may say that the resource will work on that task only 3 hours that day and 8 hours on that day. So it gives you a more flexibility in how your resources may be allocated. And within a safe PI planning, it's quite crucial to be able to define dependency or to just to build a roadmap and dependencies between your teams and so on. So it's a kind of implementation of the roadmap that is or backlog or program board. Yeah, it's called program board in SAFe, that shows you the set of iterations aligned called cadences and set of teams, right, with task allocated to each of them. So basically this grid shows you the kind of a, it gives you a quick overview of the whole roadmap for lots of teams. So basically that information is fully synchronized with Jira Agile with a variety of options. Still it's like every single cell represents a single sprint within your Jira. So as a result, yeah, I think I will skip it. Yeah, so the PI planning is basically there are some other options, but still I'm not going to focus on it, like cadence backlog, program backlog, timeline view. Yeah, if you're interested, I may just discuss it after the presentation. So the crucial thing during PI planning is to identify the interdependencies, and this is something that is available on that roadmap. So this is the same screen as presented 2 slides ago, but with more cadences visible and dependencies enabled. So you can easily switch or on and off links using menu, and you can just define a new dependencies via drag and drop, and all these dependencies are synchronized and mapped back to your Jira. So it's fully configurable, so you can choose any links, any issue link type you like, and with some defaults provided. And there are some aggregated values displayed here if you are interested. Some lots of stuff like quick filtering and other things, but yeah, or exporting this roadmap to an Excel spreadsheet for further reporting or so, if you are interested, of course. And the program level as a whole is something bigger than just a PI, it's just a program increment planning, of course. So basically, this is the roadmap. And the current roadmap, the previous screen is currently named roadmap, but we reconsider it and now we know it's not a roadmap, it's rather a program board as it is defined in a Scheduled AI framework. And the roadmap is something that is already available in the cloud, and it is a true roadmap by a safe definition with an objectives defined with some business value and actual business value. Yeah, that's not here, but it's available. So you can link objectives together, so you can link objectives on the team level to an objectives on the PI level and so on. As I mentioned before, the SAFE program overview is implemented as a Gantt chart view. If you don't like it, you don't have to use it anyway. But yeah, it's worth just configure it properly, because Gantt chart in general provides you with lots of information, very useful. And on the program level, you have also the risk management module. It's not very robust still. It provides a nice way to identify risk based on the consequences and probability. I'm just going really quickly through all of these screens because it's kind of quite. Yeah, advanced product. Yeah, so this is something we are currently that's currently in development. So it's for the backlog, and so we believe that we should provide a user interface with an ability to define all the information on the flight with an Excel-like editing, so you can navigate through the using keyboard through all of these. And you can define this WSJF priority on the task. It may be calculated automatically or maybe just set manually with a nice drag and drop capability, so you can assign the task to either program increment or cadence or directly to your team. Okay, on a portfolio level and the solution level, these are also functionality in Big Picture 7. So the roadmap, the new roadmap I showed you three or four slides ago, represent just a one agile risk train. But on the portfolio level or on a large solution level, you need an ability to see a multiple release train. So you may use this screen as a kind of a roadmap for either the whole portfolio or the whole company. Depends on depends on company's needs. So and the portfolio view is something kind of a very generic yet powerful. So that on the portfolio view, portfolio itself combines a set of programs or set of other portfolio, and these programs consist of either PI or maybe if you have a more waterfall project, a single program may consist of two parts, like one is safe oriented and one is more waterfall. So we support also the hybrid projects, which is really good, we believe, because basically Basically, it works in a way that, you know, there are lots of companies that are struggling with project management in Agile, using Agile methodologies. And even if they do Agile methodologies, they still have lots of things or part of projects managed in a waterfall way. So Big Picture is designed to support both of or three of these scenarios, to support the purely waterfall projects, safe projects, or the hybrid projects. And that's why this very generic concept of, we call it schedule hierarchy. So it's support this approach. So you may define a single portfolio, then it's really bad. Yeah, the quality is really bad, yet still it's like you may define a single portfolio, then to divide it into a kind of a set of programs. Each program may be either the safe program or the waterfall program. And if you have a safe program, you've got the program increments consisting of sprints, and each sprint consists of some kind of objective resources and some scope, etc. And it builds a hierarchy of schedule of your whole portfolio. And as a result, you can get this kind of nice, we call it simplified portfolio view. So you can take a single program or the portfolio and get this nice overview of the phases within each program, with some milestones defined on that level, etc. So I was really quick with this presentation. So sorry if I was too fast, but still as we have like 1 or 2 minutes left, it's a good option for Q&A. I'm still we have booth there, and so if you have any question, just please visit our booth. I will be happy to show you a live demo, because we have very little time, and I was so fast that I was able to do this even in a smaller amount of time. Any question? If you are interested, if you want, you may vote for the for this presentation in the conference app. So please do so. Thank you. Thank you very much.